Hi, I'm Dr. Abhishek Joshi, and in this lecture, I'm going to discuss about the concept of scrambling and the eye diagram. So in digital communication, we are using a scrambler as well as the eye diagram to analyze our signals. So what is scrambling? So in general, a scrambler tends to make the data more random by removing the long streams of ones and zeros. So in a scrambler, so why we are using a scrambler? To avoid the long strings of zeros and ones, because in digital communication what happens is that if we have the long strings of ones like this and long strings of zeros, so what the receiver thinks that the system is either off or it is shorted. So to avoid this, we are using the scrambler in order to remove the long strings of ones and zeros which was the data was transmitted. The scrambler can be helpful in timing extraction by removing long strings of zeros in binary data. So scramblers are primarily used for preventing unauthorized access to the data. They are optimized for that purpose. So there's another reason for using the scrambler. Such optimization may actually result in generation of the long strings of zeros in the data, and the digital network must be able to cope with these long zeros string by using the zero replacement technique discussed earlier. So which we have discussed in earlier lectures also. So we are using whatever data is transmitted. For example, I've explained this using this data which was transmitted. As you can see, we have the long strings of zeros, long strings of one, and so we are actually removing these long strings and ones by some pattern, and this pattern is generated by the scrambler. Now let's see which circuit is doing this and how we are performing this. So this is a generalized, you can say, the block diagram of the scrambler, where we are using these registers. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 5 shift registers, and these are the XOR, or you can say modulo sum. So here we have the XOR or the modulo sum. Both are the same thing, modulo sum, or modulo 2 addition we can call, modulo sum we can call. And here we have the data. So data input is here. Here we have the data input, which is acting as S. And this is the transmitted sequence, which is given by T. So these are the notations which we'll be using in while solving the numericals based on a scrambler. So this scrambler is used at the transmitter side. So this scrambler we are using is at transmitter side, and this is the descrambler on the right of side of the screen. We have this descrambler, and this descrambler is having again the same pattern, the same circuit, but in a different manner. Here it is in the feedback, we are using 5 shift registers, but at the receiver side the same shift registers are used in feed forward network with the same XOR circuit. So if we see, sir, our element is delayed by 3. So if we have the single data, here it will be delayed by 3. So we are denoting it as D raised to power 3, which showing the 3-bit delay. Now this again, the 3-bit delay is delayed by another 2 delay elements. Okay. So these are again providing 2 delay elements. So output of this, the 3-bit delay, and here we have 2-bit delay. So 2-bit delay and 3-bit delay will make 5-bit delay. So here we'll be having the 5-bit delay. Now here you can see, here we have 3-bit delay denoted by D raised to power 3. Here we are having the 5-bit delay denoted by D raised to power 5. Now these 3-bit delay and 5-bit delay are having the modulo addition. So output will be D raised to power 3 modulo with D raised to power 5. Now here we can see again our input data is S. So input data S is there. So initially we can see that we don't have any data earlier, because these are the delay elements and initial conditions are all data are 0. So if we have all data are 0 and 0 XOR with S will give you S. So initially the transmitted sequence at the 0th clock, you can say it is T is equals to S. Now in the next cycle and next clock cycle, what happens is that every element is having the modulo addition, and in the next cycle we will be having D raised to power 3 into that is the modulo sum with D raised to power 5. So here we can see the transmitted sequence is having the modulo sum. So transmitted sequence is nothing but S modulo sum with d raised to power 5 modulo with d raised to power 3. Okay, so we can write our transmitted sequence for the next clock cycle. Now for the another cycle, it will be the term will be again, it will provide this much delay. So if we assume that this delay function or the delay provided by the feedback network is f, for example, if we have the feedback network is f, which is providing the delay, which is given by d raised to power 3 modulo with d raised to power 5. Now again in the next clock cycle, what will happen is that again we have a feedback provided by f. So we have the f square term in the second clock cycle. Okay, so our transmitted sequence will be simply, you can write it as, that is S next modulo with F into S modulo with F square S modulo with, similarly we can write F cube S. Okay, so this pattern is followed in this particular scrambler. So if the circuit is changed for two shift registers, one shift register, accordingly we can form an equation and we can find the scrambler output. So similarly, in the D scrambler, what we are doing is we have this transmitted sequence which will be received, and here again we will be having the 3-bit delay, and this is providing the 2-bit delay. So output will be total 5-bit delay, and here will be 3-bit delay. So the output of the modulo will be the modulo sum of 3-bit delay modulo with 5-bit delay. Okay. So now here we can see, so using this we can recover our clock. Okay, and here we can see this T, again we have the modulo sum and the received bit will be given by, that is T plus that is modulo, that is F into T modulo F square T. Okay, for the next clock cycle again F cube T, like this. So this is the concept of, and this is the generalized circuit which is used for scrambler and descrambler. So this circuit can be modified with two shift register, one shift register, three shift registers. Okay, but just for the explanation, I have used the five shift registers to explain how the scrambler works. So the figure shows typical scrambler and descrambler. The scrambler consists of the feedback shift register, and the matching descrambler has a feed forward shift register, as I've discussed in this previous slide, where we have at the descrambler we have the feed forward and here we have the feedback shift register. And the matching descrambler has a feed forward shift register as shown in the figure, which we have discussed in previous slide. Each stage in the shift register delays a bit by 1 unit. To analyze the scrambler, the matched descrambler consider the output sequence which is given by T. So the notations which I have already explained in the previous slide is used for the mathematical notations of the scrambler, and the S is the input. So input series, or you can say it, input sequence is given by S in the scrambler. So we can write for the first clock cycle, that is a transmitted sequence is given by the d raised to power 3 T d raised to power 5 modulo with the input sequence S. But initially we know that T is equals to S, so what we can write it as, that is we can substitute S here, we'll be having the transmitted sequence in terms of the input sequence because the input is delayed. Okay, so D represent the delay operator, and that is d raised to power n. So if we have 1-bit delay, so we'll given by d raised to power 1. If we have 2-bit delay, it is d raised to power 2. If we have 3-bit delay, it is d raised to power 3. If we have 4-bit delay, it is d raised to power 5. So we are denoting d raised to power n into t is the sequence delayed by n units, and that will depend on the circuit, whether we are using a 3-bit shift register, whether we are using 5-bit shift register, or whether we are using 2-bit shift register. Okay, now recall the modulo 2 sum. So modulo 2 sum of any sequence with itself gives the sequence of all zeros. So what we are doing is we have the addition of d raised to power 3 modulo with d raised to power 5 in the first clock cycle. So we can write our transmitted sequence as in terms of that is the input sequence as that is given by t modulo with d raised to power 3 modulo with d raised to power 5 into t. So we can take t common, and we have this delay operator. We are writing this as the delay d raised to power 3 modulo with d raised to power 5 is delay operator, and it is 1 modulo f into t. So now we will we'll take one example and we'll solve it. So before that, we will find the sequence, that is to design the descrambler. So what will happen at the descrambler? The vice versa operations will be performed in the descrambler. To design a descrambler at the receiver, we start with t. So we are starting with the received sequence, which is t, and the sequence received at the descrambler from the equation it follows. So we have, that is t modulo with f into t. So f we have already defined, it is given by d raised to power 3 modulo with d raised to power 5. So if we substitute here, so what we get is, that is the transmitted sequence modulo with d raised to power 3 modulo with d raised to power 5 into t. So that will be our data sequence, or you can say the actual input. So this equation in which we regenerate the input sequence s from the received sequence t, readily implemented by the descrambler as shown in the figure in the previous slide. And we have to note that a single detection error in the received sequence t will affect 3 output bits in the received sequence r. So hence the scrambler has a disadvantage of causing multiple errors for single received bit error. So if we have the single bit error, due to the modulo operations, it will generate multiple errors. So this is the main disadvantage of using the scrambler. Advantage of using scrambler is the timing extraction, because we have transitions, we don't have the long streams of zeros and long streams of ones. So let's consider this numerical based on the same circuit. So we have the circuit where we have this 3-bit shift register and 2-bit shift register. The same scenario we are taking to solve this numerical. So but input we are taking here is the data stream. So for this numerical, the data stream S. So S is given by, so solution for this is given by, so we have the sequence given by S, that is 10 10 10, then we have 1 5 times 0 1 2 3 4 5 and 1 1 1. So this is our sequence, or you can say the input sequence given by S. This is fed to the scrambler shown in the figure A, which I have shown in the previous slide. Find the scrambler output T. So what we have to find? We have to find the scrambler output T, assuming that the initial condition of the register to be 0. So initially all values of the shift registers are 0. So what we will get? So we have here 0, 0, 0, 0 and 0. So this means modulo of 0 with S will give you S. So transmitted sequence for the first clock cycle will be T is equals to S. Now for the next cycle, it will be, so I can write here, that is a transmitted sequence T is given by S. For the next clock cycle, it is the feedback, that is F into S. For the next clock cycle, again it will be modulo with f square s. Again for the next clock cycle, it is f cube s. For the next clock cycle, it is f raised to power 4 s. So here we can see how many data bits are there. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14, 15. So we have 15 bits. So this means up to 15 bits, we should take our delay operator. Okay. So first we have to solve this x, or we have to expand this equation. So how we can expand? Because we know that f is given by d raised to power 3 modulo with d raised to power 5. This is f. So what will be f square? So f square is given by d raised to power 3 modulo with d raised to power 5, and d raised to power 3 modulo with d raised to power 5. Okay. So here we again the same mathematical operation we can perform. So d cube will be multiplied with d cube and d raised to power 5. So what we'll have is d cube into d cube will be d raised to power 6. So 6 bit delay modulo with d raised to power 3 and d raised to power 5 will be 8 bit delay. So that is d raised to power 8. Then we have d raised to power 5 and d raised to power 3 will make d raised to power 8 delay, and d raised to power 5 and d raised to power 5 will make d raised to power 10. So here we can see when we have the same quantity and we are XORing it, because we know that 1 XOR 1 is equals to 0, 0 XOR 0 equals to 0. So if we have the same bits, the XOR will give you 0. So this term will be equal to 0. So what we have is the f square given by, that is d raised to power 6 modulo with d raised to power 10. So this will be the first expression of f square. Now similarly we can find, that is f cube. Okay, so f cube is given by f cube, we can write as, that is d raised to power 6, we can write it as f square into f. So that is d raised to power 6 modulo with d raised to power 10 multiply with f, but which is d raised to power 3 modulo with d raised to power 5. Okay, so here we have f cube, that is d raised to power 6 we have to multiply with these two terms. So d raised to power 6 and d raised to power 3 will become d raised to power 9 modulo 6 and 5 will be 11, d raised to power 11 modulo with d raised to power 10, and d raised to power 3 will be d raised to power 13 modulo, and d raised to power 10 and d raised to power 5 will be d raised to power 15. Okay, now we can see that there are no common terms. We can solve it further, that is for d raised to power 4. Okay, so for d raised to power 4 it is f cube into f. So what we have is f cube is given by this term, d raised to power 9 modulo d raised to power 11 modulo d raised to power 13 modulo d raised to power 15 multiply with f, which is d raised to power 3 modulo d raised to power 5. So if we can see d raised to power 4, we have the term. So if you multiply 3 and 9 will be 12. So d raised to power 12 we have modulo 3 multiply by d raised to power 11, it will be d raised to power 14 modulo. Then 3 and 13 will be 16 modulo 3 and 15 will be making 18 modulo. Now d raised to power 5 and 9 will become d raised to power 14 modulo with d raised to power 5 and 11 will make d raised to power 16. Remaining are the higher terms, so we can neglect the higher terms. And we can see here we have this term, that is d raised to power 16 and d raised to power 16. So these can be cancelled out because these will make 0. And we have d raised to power 14 and d raised to power 14 here, so these two terms will be also cancelled out. What is left is, that is d raised to power 12 and d raised to power 18. So we have f square with initial terms, that is d raised to power 12 and modulo with d raised to power 18 and further higher terms. Okay, so we have to consider delay up to 15 bits because our data is up to 15 bits. Okay, so we can write our transmitted sequence. Our transmitted sequence is given by, that is T, that is S, so initially it is S, or we can take common 1 modulo with, that is D cube modulo with D5 modulo with D6 modulo with D9 modulo with, if we are substituting the values, d raised to power 10 modulo with d raised to power 11 modulo with d raised to power 12 modulo with d raised to power 13 modulo with d raised to power 15. Okay, and whole terms are multiplied by the input sequence s. Now let's solve it. So we have the data which we have to consider first. So it is given by 101010 and 1 5 times 0 111. So same data, or we can draw a table and we can solve it. So here we can see our input sequence s that is given by 101010 1 5 times 0 1 2 3 4 5 and 111 1 1 and 1. Now if we have this delay that is given by d raised to power 3, so solving for d raised to power 3 s, so we have d raised to power 3 s means 3 bit delay. So I am drawing a table to solve it. Solve for the transmitted sequence. Once again we can check the data, that is 101010 1 5 times 0 111. 101010 1 5 times 0 111. Okay, our input sequence is correct. Now 3 bit delay. So here we have d raised to power 3 into s. So we introduce 3 zeros, 1, 2, 3, and what we have, 101010 and 1 5 times 0 1 1 and 1. So this will be the 3 bit delay. Now next we have the second term, that is d raised to power 5. So there will be 5 bit delay. So d raised to power 5 into s. So we have 5 bit delay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 5 times 0, 1, 1 and 1. So this will be the 5 bit delay. Now next we have 6 bit delay. So 6 bit delay will be having 6 bits, d raised to power 6 into s, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 5 times 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 1 and 1. So that is for the 6 bit delay. Now for next term is the 9 bit delay. So d raised to power 9, so it will be d raised to power 9 into s. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, then 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, and then we have 5 times 0 and 1, 1 and 1. Okay. Next, we have 10 bit delay. So d raised to power 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, and 1, 5 times 0, 1, 1, and 1. Next, we have 11 and 12 bit delay. So, d raised to power 11. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And then we have data 101010 1 5 times 0 1 2 3 4 5 1 1 and 1. Next is 12 bit delay. So d raised to power 12 into s, so that will be 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 and 5 times 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 1 and 1. Next is 13 bit delay. D raised to power 13. So 13, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 5 times 0 and 1, 1. Next is 15 bit delay. So d raised to power 15 s, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 1 and 5 times 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So our transmitted sequence up to 15-bit delay according to our sequence is given by T, which is, so we have to take the XOR. So S XOR D raised to power 3, XOR D raised to power 5, S XOR D raised to power 6, S 9, S 10, S 11, 12, 13, 15. So we have to take the XOR of these. So 1, here we can see our data 1, then XOR 0. 1 XOR 0 will be 1. So here we have all zeros. So all zeros XOR will be given by 0. Next we have 1 and all zeros. So 1 XOR 0, we know that it is 1. Now we have the sequence that is 0, only 1 is there, so single 1 is there, so it will be 1. Here we have only single 1 in the all the streams of zeros, so it is 1. Here we have two 1s, so if we have even number of 1s, the output will be 0. If we have odd number of 1s, output will be 1. So this means here we have two 1s, so it will be 0. So here we have two 1s, so it will be 0. So here we have how many ones? Two ones. So it will be 0. Next we have only single 1, so it is 1. So 1, 2, 3. 3 ones means 1. Here we have two ones, so it will be 0. Here we have 1, 2, 3. 3 ones means 1. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 ones, it will be 0. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 ones, it will be 0. So here we have 1, 2, 3 ones, it will be 1. So our transmitted sequence, that is T, is 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. So we can write the transmitted sequence, which is this one. So this is our transmitted sequence for the given scrambler. Now the next important topic which we are going to discuss in this lecture is the eye diagram. So the eye diagram is easy to generate and is often applied on the received signal for the visual examination of severity of inter-symbol interference. So the accuracy of timing extraction, that is the noise immunity and other important factors. So that's why we are analyzing the eye diagram. And these eye diagrams are generated only for the single bit duration, and these are analyzed on this oscilloscope. Now let's see. So we need only a basic oscilloscope to generate the eye diagram. So we have the baseband signal at the channel output. So baseband signal at the channel output is given by the expression Y in terms of the pulses, or you can say the pulse train with the amplitude AK, and pulse is given by T minus K times of TB. So it can be applied to the vertical input of the oscilloscope. This is the important point. So if you apply at the vertical plates of the oscilloscope, then only it will generate the eye diagram. So the time base of the scope is triggered at the same rate. So same rate is, that is 1 by TB, because for a single bit duration it is from 0 to TB, that is a single bit duration, and we are triggering because the bit rate is given by RB, that is equals to 1 by TB. So for this bit rate we are actually exciting the vertical plates of the scope, as that the incoming pulses at it yields a sweep exactly, that is TB, the interval of the one transmitted data, that is AK, because we are talking about the single bit duration. The oscilloscope shows the superposition of many traces of length TB, because we have the single bit duration given by duration, that is TB, as indicated here. If the bit is given by BT here, and it is with respect to time. From the channel output, that is given by YT, what appears on the oscilloscope is simply the input signal. So we have the input signal cut off at every TB second. So if we have, for example, we have the bit given by 101. So now this 101 will be overlapped. How it will be overlapped? As we can see here, this is our oscilloscope, and from 0 to TB it will show. Okay, so we have first 1. So in the polar form I am drawing, it is 1 here. Next is 0. 0, 0 is given by minus 1. Next bit is 1, so it will be overlapped to 1. So as we can see, these are forming a rectangular block if we are talking about the rectangular pulses. So more generally, we can also apply the time sweep that lasts in the symbol interval that is given by m times of tb. Consider a channel that is distortive and has finite bandwidth or both. After passing through the non-ideal channel, the NRZ polar signal of figure A becomes the waveform of E, and the received signal pulse are no longer the rectangular but be rounded, because these are the practical pulses which we have the rounded and the distorted and spread out. The eye diagram are not fully open anymore in the figure F. So we will be discussing the figure in the next slide as I show you. So we are talking about these. If we have the rectangular pulses, it is given by these pulses. If we have the rounded pulses, that is our practical pulses, then we have the eye diagram look like this, because all the data stream, because data stream is given by 10110111001, and we have the, for the single bit duration it is TB, and for 2-bit duration, that is twice of TB, it is drawn. So for practical pulses, we can see we have this pattern, and these patterns are look like the eye diagram. That's why it is called as the eye diagram. Okay, so if we have due to the Gaussian channel, for example, these pulses are delayed, so eye diagram will be having the crossings, and due to these crossings we can see that eye is actually having the less width and the less height, and we will analyze that what happens if we have the less width and less eyes for the eye diagram. So the eye diagrams are not fully open anymore, as we have seen in the figure F. So in this case, the ISI is not zero, as the pulse value at the respective sampling instant will deviate from the full scale values in each trace, resulting in the partially closed eye diagram. So this figure, we can see here we have the eye diagram figure in this form, and we have the slope showing the sensitivity to sampling time, and we have the level crossing, and ambiguity shows the jitter. So if we have the zero here, if we have the crossing here at TB, and there is a slight shift, so these crossing of these pulses is showing the level crossing. So this is the level crossing, and the height from the level crossing to the minima will give you the noise margin at the best sampling point, and we have the optimum sampling instant at maximum time eye opening. So here it is. So error free sampling region is this one in eye diagram. So reading, how we can read the eye diagram. Now what are the important points in eye diagram? The maximum operating opening point. So maximum opening point, we can see, so here we have the maximum opening point. So this is shows the eye opening amount at the sampling decision instant indicate the amount of the noise the detector can tolerate without making an error. The quantity is known as the noise margin. So this is the important point, this is the noise margin, and the instant of maximum eye opening indicate the optimum sampling of decision making instant. Another important thing is sensitivity to timing jitter. So the width of the eye indicate the time interval over which the correct decision is still made, and this is known, this is given by the maximum horizontal opening. So that will be the sensitivity to timing jitter. Another important point is the level crossing timing jitter. So level crossing timing jitter is a practical receiving exact timing information about the pulse rate and the sampling clock from the zero level crossing of the received signal waveform, and the variation of the level crossing can be seen from the width of the eye commerce. So here we can see the eye diagram of the polar signaling, because in polar signaling we have plus voltage and minus voltage. So using the raised cosine pulses with a roll-off factor that is 0.5, we have the two symbol per duration. So here, this is for the single bit duration TB, and this is for the 2-bit duration twice of TB. Here we have the shifted version, that is TB by 2 without a shift version. So here we can see these are having the raised cosine pulses, and these are forming the shape of the eye. And if this width of the eye is small, or the height is small, so we can see that there is a sensitivity of timing jitter, or there is a delay in the pulses. So in this lecture we have discussed about the scrambling, and we have discussed about the eye diagram in digital communication. So here I am going to stop this lecture. Thank you.